Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today in this video we will code this Figma design from scratch using HTML and CSS. I have already created one version and I have deployed it on GitHub, so I will tell you guys like how to code it, and this will be the behavior. Like there will be these sections similar to the design we have here, and we will deploy this on GitHub. Okay, then let's get started. As you can see, I have already done some basic setups. We'll be using this font family Roboto, and I have done some setups for the value of h1, h3 and p tags, as well as we'll be using font awesome for icons. So first we have to create this nav bar, and we'll put a comment for each of the section that we'll be creating. So let's create parent div. We'll put a class nav container, and here we'll have three anchor tags. And one for skills as well as project. Now let's save it. So now it's coming like that. We'll have to apply some CSS. Dot nav container. We'll put a background. So this will be the color. Now we need to give some padding also. I'll use this Chrome inspector. So we need to give a padding of 20 pixel. Now to move these anchor links to the right, we'll put a display flex, and flex direction will be by default row, so we have to put justify content flex end. Now if you load it, you can see this is coming here. Now we'll have to apply some properties on these A tags, so we'll put container A, and we'll put text decoration none, and margin right 50 pixel, color black. So our nav bar is done now, and we have to move to the next hero section. So here we have text, content, resume button and an image section. So now let's code it. We will do it using flex or blue background. Let's put a class of blue parent, and here we will have a div class hero container. Now here we will have two div, one for the content and one for image. For the content one, we will put class hero content, and for the image we'll put hero image. Okay, so first we need to put blue background to blue parent. Now inside the hero content we'll have h1 with this value, and a p tag with content, and we have a button as well, so we'll use a tag for that. For now I'm putting hashtag. You can put your resume link. And here we will have an image. So I have already kept one image. You can use your own. Alt tag as. profile image. We'll put all tag as profile image. Now if we load, so this is our design is coming. We need to apply display flex. So on the hero container, we'll put display flex. So now by default flex direction will be row. Now what exactly do we want is, we want to give this content thing 75% and this one is 25% of the parent width. Like we'll use flex 2 for this thing and flex 1 for this portion. So for the hero content, we'll put flex 2 and for hero image, we'll put flex 1. Now if we save it, we need to put some value for the image as well. So for hero image and img tag inside, we'll put height 250 pixel, width 250 pixel, and a border radius 50% for that circular effect. Now you can see we have this design. Now we need to give some padding to the hero container. So we'll put a padding of 120 pixel from top and 80 pixel from left and right. So this is the design we are currently getting. We need to put a max width of 1100 pixel and margin auto to move it into the center, to move it into the center from both sides. So now this is our design. Now we need to put this image into the center of this box. Like if you will see, this is the parent div containing the image and this is the portion of image. Now we want to move it into the center. So we'll put display flex here as well and justify content center. Now this image is in the center. Now we need to apply some properties here on this h1 and p tags. So we'll put hero content and h1 tag, max width of 500 pixel for the desktop and margin bottom of 50 pixel. Similarly for the p tag we will do same. Now if we save, now it's looking much better. And now we need to apply this button. We'll put a background of and padding 17 pixel from top and bottom and 32 pixel from left and right, and a font size of 18 pixel. Now if we save it, this is our design. So we need to put color white. And also we need to put a border radius of 8 pixel. So now our header section is done. And we'll move to skill section. We'll have a title and this bottom border, as well as we'll use grid to create this section. So first we'll create a parent container and we'll name it class as a skill container. There we'll have h1. And a span and below this we'll create div container which will wrap all skills. Knowledge created for one skill, and we'll put class is equal to skill item, and here we'll have a p tag like for HTML, and now we'll have a div with the class is equal to outer div. Class is equal to outer div for that gray box, and div class is equal to HTML div. Now we'll repeat this skill item. Let's put one more for CSS. Now if you see the content, this is how it is coming, and we need to apply CSS properties. So first we'll put skills container, we'll put a padding of 20 pixel, display flex, justify content center, line item center, max width of 1100 pixel, margin auto. Now let's save it. Okay, so this is how it is coming. We need to put flex direction column. Now we need to put the border, bottom and spacings. So for that we will select H1 tag. Padding bottom 20 pixel and a border bottom 3 pixel solid, and this will be the color. And similarly for that span content, we'll put a margin top 20 pixel. Now if we reload, it's looking fine. Now we need to create that grid. So for that we'll select this container class. And we'll put a display grid and a grid template column of repeat to auto. So now they are coming closer to each other. We need to apply some CSS to this design, as well as we'll put width of 100%. And a grid gap. And a grid gap of 40 pixel. Okay, now it's looking fine. Now let's create those gray and blue boxes. So we'll have dot auto div with a width of 100%. Height of 10 pixel, border radius 6 pixel. So this is how it's coming. We need to increase the width. We need to increase the height. So let's put it 20 pixel. Now it's looking fine. What we can do is, let's design dot HTML div. Everything will be same. We'll increase this width to 60%, and background will be this. You can change this 60% to whatever the percent you want. And now if you'll see the design, so this is how it is. You can adjust that width accordingly. Now we need to put some spacing to that HTML text, so we'll put dot skill item end p margin bottom 10 pixel. Similarly for the CSS div, we'll put 40. It's looking fine. Now what we need to do, we need to increase this padding to 80 pixel, and as well we'll repeat this thing 2 more times, like for git and one for JS. Let's create those diffs as well. So we need to change it here as well, git and JS. Let's move it to 80%. Now if we reload, we need to save it. Yeah, now it's looking fine. So our about section is done, skill section is done. Now we need to create this project section. And now the project section is similar to a skill section. We will use grid to create this layout. So I've created this HTML portion. We will have a parent div for blue section, as well as a container div which will contain my projects. And here we will have this projects item container div, which will have projects with a title, p tag, and what is the text tag that we are using, and we will repeat this. So now if you save it, this is what we are getting, and we need to design it. So now let's apply CSS properties. We'll use dot projects. Container, and the design will be similar to skills container. So we'll copy paste this CSS here. Now if we save it, we can see this is coming like that. Now we need to apply this CSS of h1. So we'll copy this, we'll replace this with this. Now that bottom will come. Now we need to create the design using grid. So for this project's item container, so we'll apply a display of grid here. And we'll put grid template column. Repeat to auto. And we'll put width 100%. So now you can see this is how it is coming. We'll put a grid gap of 80 pixel. And to each project we'll apply some class. Dot project. Border 1 pixel solid gray. Now let's inspect this CSS class. So we have padding 40 pixel and border is 3 pics. So now we are getting this region. We need to apply border radius. Put border radius of 16 pixel. Now we need to apply some margin top to this content, which is coming from this p tag. So we'll write dot project p tag with a margin top of 20 pixel. So now this is done, as well as we need that padding top there. So for project item container, we'll put padding top of 50 pixel. Okay, now it's looking good. So this section is also done, and now we need to design this footer. So we will use Font Awesome for these icons. So we'll put a div for class is equal to footer. We'll have two divs. Class is equal to socials, and one will be p tag developed by John. Okay, now we need to put the icons. So we'll put our icon links here, and I'm putting hrfh hashtag. You can change this thing. So now if we reload, this is how it is coming. We need to apply CSS. So we'll put dot footer padding of 20 pixel, display flex justify content center, align item center, and flex direction column. Let's save it. So this is how it is coming, and we need to increase the spacing as well as icon size. So we'll apply margin bottom 10 pixel, and on FA, and we'll apply some classes to this 5 icons. Font size 25 pixel. Color, let's put it as black for now. And margin right of 20 pixel. So this is the design, and we need to put an ID to each of them about a skills and project if we are missing anything. Here we are putting as projects. ID is equal to skills. ID is equal to about skills projects. And for the scroll behavior, we are putting this HTML scroll behavior smooth. So when we'll click on it, it will go there smoothly like this. So our desktop design is completely done. For the mobile version, I want you to do it on your own. Like, you can use media query as I have explained in earlier lectures. So now we'll push this code to GitHub and we will deploy there, and our portfolio will be live. Now we'll create a new repository. You can name it whatever you want, or you can put it as your name. Create a repository. Let's copy this link. We'll open a new terminal. Let's first of all do git init. Now I will do git add dot git commit. We can put it as first commit, and then we'll push it to master branch. It's done. Now the code will come to this John repository. Now to host it, we have to go to the settings, and inside here we have to go to pages, and inside here we have to select master, and we need to save it. Okay, so now if we open this link, this is giving 404, but we need to wait for a moment and our page will load. So now you can see that our portfolio is live, and the domain name is your GitHub ID, and that github.io/ the project folder that, and it's working totally fine. You can see this smooth scroll behavior is working fine and everything is done. So now try to build that mobile version on your own using media query. And yeah guys, if you are new to this channel, do subscribe and share video with your friends. See you soon in a new project.